Shit, man. This is all yours?
Don't sound so surprised.
When you said that you had a nice place, I was picturing small but homey.
Well then, welcome to my crib.
Seriously, this is great.
And the best part is, it's actually yours. I'm mostly staying at Charlotte's now.
Gabe, I love it.
Good.
I mean it. I don't know what to say.
You can say thank you. Or maybe you're the best. Or I'm definitely naming my first and third born children Gabriel or Gabriella.
Sure thing. Didn't we already do the whole staring at me thing?
It's just, you look a lot like how I imagined you'd be.
Yeah?
Do I look how you expected?
I honestly didn't expect you to have a beard.
Oh, they didn't tell you? When you move to Colorado, you automatically get an amazing beard, a pretentious knowledge of craft beers, and a Subaru.
Funny. I didn't get any of those things.
Don't worry, I will stop at nothing to get you your very own Colorado welcome kit.
Good, because I actually got you something.
Wait, what?
Surprise.
Wait, is this? This is the album I requested.
I know, I'm good.
I was gonna get this for you.
Well, I got it for you first, so I get the credit.
Like old times.
Oh no. Stop that.
I can't. It's too late.
Oh yeah, go get him, bro.
Lifetime of practice. Your turn.
Fine.
Give me a sec. Yeah! Hey, Mac. Can I help you?
Something's wrong.
I read Riley's phone. I know you've been meeting with her behind my back.
It's not what you think, Mac.
Oh, good. Because I thought you were fucking my girlfriend!
Dude, I promise, you've got it all wrong.
Tell me why I shouldn't kick your ass right now!
No. No, 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 not here. No, no, not here!
Not my place, Mac.
You really need to talk to your girlfriend.
I'm talking to you!
It's okay.
Your sister's fucking psycho. You could both go fuck yourselves.
I'm so sorry.
Don't worry about it.
Wait, Gabe.
Alex, it's fine. I gotta go stop my shift.
Great. I'm okay. I'm okay. I'm okay. I guess I might as well unpack. Is that a sword? We didn't even get to finish the song. Huh. I've really changed the art style since I read these. Must be Ethan's. Wonder how many times Gabe's been forced to play. Wait, what? Is that a real live, dead deer? Gabe brushing up on comics and art? Really going the extra mile for Ethan and Charlotte. Holy shit. It looks like Gabe actually read this.
broadcasting straight from your local record store. Because how fucking cool is that?
At least I held it together in front of Ryan and Steph. Whoa. Looks like Ryan turned my brother into a model citizen.
So Gabe and Riley have been working on her interview, and Mac thought they were sleeping together. This is fucking stupid. Alex, do I want to know? Guess I kind of gave Gabe the runaround, huh? Anita and Eduardo. They were one of the good ones. Wow, Gabe's been looking for me for a while.
His story doesn't add up. He wants you.
He's helping me get into college, baby. You know dudes can do nice things without the expectation of getting laid, right?
A high school dropout? A guy who went to fucking juvie? Wants to be your study buddy? What, out of the goodness of his heart?
Oh my God, Mac, we're friends. There is nothing going on between Gabe and me.
Gabe always wanted a bike like this. I know it kicked the drywall crack when I see one.
Looks like we've both had people trying to help us. I'm glad it made a difference for Gabe.
But it looks like Mr. John Chin left San Miguel County about 6 months after his arrival.
Yeah, is there like a forwarding address on file?
I'm sorry, sir. That's not information we retain. Thanks again for calling the San Miguel County Clerk's Office. Have a pleasant afternoon.
No! Hey, don't!
Gabe looks like he fits right in. Oh man, Gabe used to crush me. Jerk.
What an honor to be the sister of the Rubber Duck Derby second place finisher.
No way. Gabe has this photo too? Look at our parents. Mom's healthy, Dad's only... Oh God, Shushu's gonna look so grungy on this nice bed. She's gotten me through some hard times, but I was hoping we were done with that. Ethan's really talented.
Ethan's really talented.
We've seen things, haven't we, Shushu? I never heard back from Sydney. I hope she's okay.
At least she cared. More than I can say for most.
I really wish those meds had worked.
Chelsea, the rare bright spot from my time in the group home. Crazy how much we've changed.
It's really nice that Gabe and I both held on to this photo. My journal. Time to add my latest meltdown. Ugh. I'll finish this later. No fucking way. Well, Alex, you just went nuts and beat the shit out of somebody in front of your brother. So, how are you feeling right now?
When you were here before, couldn't look you in the eye. Dressed like an angel, your skin makes me cry. You float like a feather in a beautiful world. I wish I was special. You're so very special. But I'm a creep. I'm a weirdo. What the hell am I doing here? I don't belong here. Whatever makes you happy, whatever you want, you're so very special. God, I wish I was special, but I'm a creep. I'm a weirdo. What the hell am I doing here? I don't belong here. I don't belong here.
You and your damn surprises, Gabe. Being here is too good to be true. I'm not gonna let anything mess it up. I should go downstairs and set things right with Gabe.
Brian, just forget it.
Stop that. You need to take care of yourself.
Got Mac patched up. Let's take a look at you now. Oh, looks pretty nasty right about here. So, it hurts when you breathe?
Alex, you made it. Charlotte, right?
Put some ice on it.
I'm sorry you had to see that fight. What a terrible first impression.
Dad, I'm taking Gabe to the station. We need a first aid kit that doesn't predate the discovery of bacteria.
It's fine. I don't need to go.
Well, Ryan knows what he's doing. Now you just go with him.
Alex, I'll be back soon, okay?
Okay.
Now, there goes my bartender and my backup bartender.
I love that. It's a falling star?
Yeah. Or rising. Depends on the day, I guess.
So, what's it doing today?
Falling pretty damn hard.
Yeah?
I mean, I guess. But it's amazing to be here.
I heard Ethan gave you an issue of his comic. He obviously thinks you're really cool.
I know literally nothing about kids, but he seems like one of the good ones.
I appreciate that. He's my favorite person. By the way, thanks for telling us about the mine. Ethan's not allowed up there anymore.
Yeah, no problem. I hope you won't be mad at me.
You did the right thing.
Beef pie special. Watch the gravy.
Jed, you didn't have to.
Now, Ryan said you're skipping dinner. No starving artists on my watch.
I do have to get going. I'm making some pieces for the Spring Festival, and they have to be done tonight. Sorry I couldn't talk longer.
Oh, that's okay.
So glad you're here, Alex. I'm looking forward to getting to know you.
Yeah, same.
Bye. Thanks for supper.
Yep.
Thank you.
So I'm short-staffed at the moment. Gabe tells me you've worked at a restaurant before. A couple years' experience as a server?
Maybe not as long as that, but yeah, I've done lots of things.
You want to work a shift? See if you might like it here?
Sure.
All right. So, we have a few folks that need checking on. Ducky and Diane over there. Steph over here. There's a table in the back that needs clearing also. You can give the food orders to me, and I'll handle anyone here at the bar. All right?
Got it.
It's really nice to have you here, Alex.
Thanks.
Guess I'm a server now. Let's see how this goes.
My dad was in the service.
Still want to hit the trails later this week?
Are you kidding?
Shit. Now Mac's scared. At least he's not freaking out anymore. He won't make me lose control. Yeesh. Glad I'm not a 19th century miner. Haven seems pretty proud of its mining history. Haven seems pretty serious about this festival. Nineteen lives? Jed is a real hero. Coupons for weed? What a time to be alive. How mysterious.
Idiot. You're gonna lose her. You're gonna lose her, and it's all your fault.
At least he's right about something. Wow, I messed Mac up pretty good.
Idiot. You're gonna lose her. You're gonna lose her, and it's all your fault.
Jed asked me to clear that off. Holy shit.
Can I talk to you real quick?
What do you want?
Listen. What happened upstairs was fucked up, right? From both of us.
Where are you going with this?
Look, Riley's headed over here. She's pretty heated. I don't think it helps to recap all the gory details, you know?
So you're saying you want me to lie to cover your ass?
No. No, just, like, let me handle it. Look, she's gonna break up with me otherwise. We've been together 4 years. She is the best thing that's ever happened to me. So please, help me out.
I don't know, man.
Shit.
What the fuck is wrong with you? Oh my god, look at your face.
No, it's okay.
Don't even. What were you thinking? Where's Gabe?
Why do you give a shit?
Because my boyfriend just got into a fight with him. I swear. This is it.
better have a good explanation or we're done.
It's not my fault. I just wanted to talk to the guy.
About what?
About you! About why you guys are meeting behind my back.
Okay. So how did the fight happen?
The bastard sucker punched me. Okay, not exactly sucker punched, but he definitely started it.
Oh, God. Were you there too?
Yeah, I was there. Max telling you a whole lot of bullshit.
You know what? That doesn't even surprise me anymore. So what really happened?
Riley.
Mac barged in, accused Gabe of sleeping with you, sucker punched him, and then kicked him while he was down.
Riley, listen.
What happened to Mac's face?
I did that.
Well, good. It sounds like he deserved it. Thanks for telling me the truth, Alex.
Wait, are we okay?
Are you fucking serious? I'm so embarrassed by you right now.
But are we still together?
What do you think, you fucking idiot? No.
Alex Chen?
Assaulting
Mac Loudon on your first day here, huh? I'm Jason Pike, the deputy sheriff. I'm gonna have to take you in for questioning.
Mac assaulted Gabe. He's the one you want.
Your face. You should see your face. Oh, jeez. No, oh, I'm only kidding. Nobody's in trouble here. Gabe and I just like to prank each other.
I've never been pranked by a cop before. You definitely got me.
Thanks for being a good sport. Can I buy you a drink?
Maybe. I'm working right now.
Well, I'll be at the bar. You want one, you just come by, okay?
Christ, she did that to that guy's face? Steering clear.
Aw, I'm already making friends. This one's from yesterday. Is that Gabe's couch? Damn. I wonder if the bullet's still in there. Rest in peace, mister. Guess these were for mining. Maybe I'll see a circus one day. Once I'm better with crowds. Unusually personable staff. Nicely done, big bro. Is there anything this woman can't do?
Damn, boys, always fighting. Time to grow up.
Should have seen Gabe go at it with Dad. He's come a long way. Jed acts so humble. Maybe that's part of being a hero. Venison and leek pie. I need to try that.
I should check on that table. Can I get you two anything?
Miss Chen! Here at last to relieve our suspense.
Hi.
I am Reginald McAllister, the third, Ducky, to friends, former entrepreneur, now retired. And this young woman is Diane.
Hey there.
Nice to meet you. I didn't realize that...
That we all knew you were coming? Yes. Gabe is generous with both friendship and information.
You're from Portland, right? I moved here from D.C. 6 months ago. How are you finding the small town thing?
I didn't really know what to expect, but it's kind of perfect. It feels like a home.
I know. I really thought I would hate it. Then I saw the mountains, met some people, and now I'm never leaving.
Diane is a geologist, recently working as a process manager for Typhon Mining.
I'm glad there's another newbie around here, too.
Can I get you anything?
Oh, yeah, we're super hungry. I'd love a pie special with fries.
Cheeseburger with mushrooms, and my usual to drink. Jed will know what to do.
All right, I'll go put that order in.
Thanks.
My dad was in the service.
That's Charlotte's dispensary. She seems cool.
Hey, Jed.
Yeah?
I've got an order from Ducky and Diane.
Go ahead.
One burger with mushrooms.
Uh-huh. And?
One pie special with mushrooms?
Ducky asked for his usual?
Yeah, he did.
Yeah, he's fond of a particular rye whiskey. I keep a personal bottle for him. Oh, that's odd. I don't see it. Oh, now wait. I bet Ducky took that bottle upstairs last night. Yeah, he and Gabe went on carousing long after closing.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Serves him right if you ask me. But feel free to go upstairs and look for it. I'm sure he'd be grateful. Oh, Deputy Pike was with them and might have some idea. If you still trust him after that prank.
Wow. Tetanus, anyone? I hope Brian's got better supplies.
Typhon's not a bad company. Once you get used to how they operate...
Starting over from scratch like this?
Right.
Fucking yeah, terrifying is what it is.
You're telling me.
Takes a minute to learn the ropes, though. Huh?
My extensive wilderness map reading knowledge tells me that there is a whole lot of wilderness around here.
Yeah, I get... Yes. The way they do things is just so...
That looks radioactive.
Idiosyncratic.
Only $45 for the chance to get mauled by a bear. That's the girl from the record store. Steph.
Alex, right? I'm Steph.
Hey. Just seeing if you need food or anything.
Oh, no. I'm good. Thanks, though. Sorry I couldn't hang out at the record store. I've got some time now, though, if you want to chat.
So, are you, here with somebody? Or...
That's Ryan's stuff. Apparently he ditched me for Gabe.
They went to get first aid.
Being a hero again. Ryan's always doing that. It's a Lucan family thing. Have you heard about Jed's rescue?
I saw some stuff on the walls.
People here still talk about it. The tourism board wanted to make a movie.
I can't imagine. Alex wants an earload of Haven trivia just now.
Sorry, Jed. He's so modest, it's ridiculous.
Is that record store inventory?
No, it's character stats. Do you know what a LARP is?
I've heard the term before.
Live action roleplay. It's like a tabletop role-playing game, but acted out in real life. Costumes, foam weapons, beanbag spells. It's great.
Gabe was talking about a LARP with Ethan.
Yeah, it's next week. They're coming with me. It's their first time. I'm so excited. Would you ever want to join us sometime?
Sure, I'd try it. If you and Gabe both like it, it must be super fun.
Awesome.
Is that your shot? What is that?
This is bedazzled kiwi schnapps. No one's ever ordered it, so Gabe's trying to get rid of it with the jukebox game.
What's a jukebox game?
It's like a short version of 20 questions, where you're trying to guess a song, guess wrong. You have to take the shot. Ryan and I are going to play. You want to take his place?
Dude, you're on.
Yes. So, I'll pick a song. You have 5 yes or no questions before you have to guess it.
Okay.
Got one. Jukebox is all yours. So, what do you want to ask me?
I should flip through these and see what might be good to ask. Is there any punctuation in the song title?
Nope.
Okay. Does the band name have a person's name in it?
Nope.
Okay. Are there people on the cover?
No. Yeah, no. You've got 2 questions left.
Does the song have a long title, like 4 words or more?
Yes.
Interesting.
Last question.
Yeah, all right, I know. When was the last time you listened to this song?
So, I guess we're breaking the yes or no questions only rule.
Can you handle it?
When was the last time I heard that song? Like 2 days ago. Gabe was working, so Char and I put it on and danced like crazy to rub it in.
That doesn't tell me anything.
What did you expect? That's your 5. Ready to guess?
Yeah. Let me look through one last time. Here's what I know. The band name doesn't have a person's name in it. No punctuation in the song title. The song title is at least 4 words long. No people on the cover. And it could be a dance song.
Think that's enough to figure it out?
We'll see. Here's what I know. The band name doesn't have a person's name in it. No punctuation in the song title. The song title is at least 4 words long. No people on the cover. And it could be a dance song. Is it that one?
No, it's not. Sorry.
All right. Glitter drank me.
It's not as bad as it looks. How was it?
It's actually delicious. You should try one.
Hey, thanks for playing. I'm really glad we did.
Me too. I should get back to work.
Okay.
I've done what Jed asked me to do. I should see if he needs anything else.
Hey.
I got written up for leaving my phone.
Damn, is that drink out of line? But I guess did I come on too strong?
It was bold. Duty. I'll give you that.
Yeah, they're sticklers about that stuff.
Hey, Alex.
It's a security concern.
I mean, sure, but it's not like the CIA.
Were you hanging out with Ducky and Gabe last night?
Who told?
So, Ducky apparently lost his favorite whiskey. Possibly upstairs?
I don't know.
You remember seeing him with it?
No, when I left, he was still down here. Oh, but you know what? You should check Gabe's wall of shame. Might have some incriminating evidence. And the Oscar
goes to... Actually, I did see Ducky up there.
I knew it. Well, worth looking again. Could be some clues.
I'm ready to take you up on that drink.
All right. Wait, hey, Jed, can we get,
Thanks.
And keep it quick. She's on the clock.
You know, your brother's been talking about you getting here for months.
I'm starting to get the sense.
I even remember exactly the day he found your number. He was telling everybody in this place.
Really?
Yeah. Pretty heartwarming stuff.
Well, I've got to get back to work.
Later, Alex.
Ducky? Jed thinks you took your whiskey up to Gabe's yesterday. Do you know where you might have left it?
I remember absolutely nothing of the night.
Really?
Maybe check your phone. Did you take any pictures, call anyone?
Have a look.
For goodness sake.
How do I access the photos on this thing?
Sorry, nothing useful.
Well, thanks for letting me know.
My dad was in the service.
This one's from yesterday. Hold up. It was Colonel Ducky on Gabe's couch with the bottle. All right, let's see if I can find Ducky's whiskey up here.